Next up.
Please run to the stage, David Broncano. It's one hell of a name. Start the clock.
Hello. How are you?
Mismo en Londres voy así. Yo lo que quiero es petarlo mañana y hacer hacia España. Cosa que no va a suceder, pero mis ilusiones. Y este fue mi debut, sí, es una sala bonita.
Yeah.
Esto es otro que ha venido a Londres a abortar.
Mucho riesgo porque, claro, es una lengua que no conoce, un público cero, un sitio mítico. Entonces se presenta en una ocasión desastrosa. Es innecesario, pero por eso es divertido. Sobre todo para los que esperamos sus fracasos, pues está bien que él vaya de cabeza por ello.
Tú vas como una materia absoluta y entonces te dan como mucho 5 minutos y como mínimo que te echen nada más entrar porque es gracioso. O sea, te pueden llegar a echar por... ¡Está a tomar por culo a España otra vez, hijo de puta! Te podrían echar 5 segundos. Yo, mis previsiones son... Menos de un minuto me cagaría en la puta. No puede pasar. Menos de un minuto sería, pues igual estos 300 euros solo del billete de avión igual no han merecido mucho las velas. Entre uno y entre, dos o tres minutos el que gane, creo que le dé que actúa en una actuación profesional
en el Comedy Store
cobrando en libras y se pone un piso.
Joder, a ver qué tal va, pero no nervios. Hombre, es verdad que normalmente yo hasta ahora me estaré comiendo 15 chuletas de choto y hoy no me entra más que una ensalada asquerosa. Es porque aquí el clima y tal te lleva a lo vegetal, pero... O sea, nervios no. Estoy bien. El que estás disfrutando aquí eres tu hijo de puta. Yo me pongo en tu lugar y estaría de vaya puto fin de semana magnífico estoy echando. Porque solo vienes a disfrutar. Y yo estoy desde las 9 a.m. que me he levantado. ¿Por qué cojones estaré haciendo? ¿Qué necesidad tenía yo pudiendo irme a las fiestas de mi pueblo? Un poco decir quién me mandaba a mí venir aquí. Pero como cosa... Como cosa hipotética. Pero ya te digo que lo que es nervios, no. O sea, no estoy nervioso.
Claro.
No estoy...
I wanted to talk to you about one of Britain's biggest frauds, biggest scams, basketball team, no fish and chips, no, Tower of London. I came from Madrid yesterday. And as soon as you arrived, I know what you're thinking now. You're like, look, he's Spanish, but he's wearing clothes. Like, how's that possible? It's true. You got me. In fact, I got to buy these pants this morning here in London because we don't have this kind of thing in Spain. In my village, we wear like, you know, those hats made out of squirrels. We don't have that kind of shit. When I go back to my village, people wearing jeans. People gather around me. They start to touch me. The mayor of the town, they start to touch me and they are like, oh my God, but what is this? What is this strange fabric? Are you from the future? What's going on here? Are you a warlock? How can you know what time is it if it's cloudy today? What are you doing? Anyway, as I was saying, I came from Madrid and the first thing I did as soon as the plane arrived, I went right to the Tower of London. I was excited to see it, you know, a temple of torture. I expected to see all kinds of creepy things, you know, human leftovers, body parts, people cut in half, rivers of blood, Paul Gascoigne with a fishing rod and a chicken. How crazy was that? However, as soon as I arrived, they started to piss me off just from the ticket window. Said, £22. £22? Really? £22? That's my monthly wage in Spain. Come on, and I'm a sergeant. We're really fucked up. We are waiting for you to make a Life Aid concert for Spain. We really depend on it. Please do it. Paul McCartney sings for Spain. Please, por favor. Anyway, I obviously couldn't pay for it. So I had to kill a swan in the Thames. So I could get inside for free. They escorted me. And as soon as I was in, I was dying to go to the bloody tower, because I read, according to the leaflet they give you, it was where all the torture happened, where the magic was done. I went in, but they show you like this single small room with only three harmless torture devices, like, you know, this thing that stretches your arms and your legs, and it's like, oh, how painful is that? You're very painful. Look, my mother does that every morning after her morning walk. I have seen more painful things in the Gay Pride Parade. Yeah, that's true, you know it. Some of you, I guess. Anyway, maybe we are a bit used to it. We don't get easily impressed with these kinds of things in Spain. We had the Spanish Inquisition, you know. Those motherfuckers were hardcore. They invented that shit. They would cut off your hand and smack you in the face with it. Come on. I tell you, when someone smacks you in the face with your own hand, maybe you start to think you have done something wrong. look, you reconsider your life, your sins. Oh my God, maybe I'm blameful for that. Anyway, we got. Yeah, you liked it. Okay. The worst was still to come. There was a sign inside the Bloody Tower, a small sign on the wall, saying, literally, since 1105, between 10 to 20 people have been tortured or executed in the Bloody Tower. 10 to 20? Really? Are you kidding me? 10 to 20 people in the Bloody Tower in 900 years? That's a bloke every 80 years. You don't name it the Bloody Tower for some torture every half century. You name it the Bloody Tower because there is plenty of finger cutting, rib crushing, nail ripping, as if they were in a fucking factory line of torture. You know, I even can imagine it with the prisoners lying on a moving belt and some workers with a hammer, another with a couple of pliers.
That's David Brancano, finalist number two.
All the way from Spain, ladies and gentlemen.
He's from Essex.